There's not many holidays left that still involve a serious challenge. One where you know you'll be exhausted, your feet will probably hurt, and the weather can turn on you in an instant. But there is a huge payoff at the end of it all, and that's what the Overland Track is all about. It's one of the truly great Aussie experiences.
The Overland Track crosses the Cradle Mountain Lake St Clair National Park, about 2.5 hours west of Launceston. The entire track is 65 kilometres long, and I'm getting a taste of it with the team from Cradle Mountain Huts Walk. Our guide, Andy Pointer, leads us through button grass plains that quickly turn to rainforest. On the shores of Crater Lake, sunshine gives way to snow.
Well, Andy, I was not expecting to see a boat shed here.
Yeah, well, it's quite amazing, actually. The boat shed you see behind us actually belonged to a guy called Gustav Weindorfer, who was, I guess you could say, an early visionary for conservation in the area. And he and his wife came up here and made this their home in the early 1900s. And he sort of saw this area as a place that needed protecting, and in his words, for the people for all time.
Gustav got his wish. The entire Overland Track is now part of the Tasmanian World Heritage Area.
It's windy enough up here to blow a dog off a chain, and these act like a sail.
This part of the track is definitely a hard slog, but the scenery at the summit is worth every step.
Marion's lookout. Almost the highest point on the whole Overland Track, so theoretically from here it's all downhill. So behind us you can see the beautiful Cradle Mountain, and down here we've got Dove Lake.
You've got to be prepared for everything, don't you? How beautiful.
A lone kitchen hut welcomes us to a well-earned lunch break.
So Will, you've done the Overland Track a few times. What Yes. attracts you back to it every time?
I think the diversity. Yeah, I mean, even what we've done this morning, we've been from high alpine to temperate rainforest. It's an amazing place to see a diversity of the landscape.
As we walk along the base of Cradle Mountain, Andy makes sure we don't miss the small details that make up the big picture.
You know, this beautiful snow gum here, the rain sort of illuminated all the colours in the bark, and even down in front of us here we've got the Tasmanian native pepperberry.
Can you eat the leaves?
You can if you're brave, but it's got a real spice to it. And
it does.
Yeah.
It's very strong.
The hut we're headed to is under Barn Bluff, that towering mountain in the distance. But one thing I can tell you for sure, if you do walk the track, you'll surprise yourself with what you can overcome. And there's always that magnificent scenery to inspire you.
Cradle Mountain looks like it's been dusted with icing sugar, doesn't it?
It certainly does. It looks truly amazing.
And after our 11k walk, the end is suddenly in sight.
Barn Bluff Hut.
Oh, I can see the fire burning. That is one of the best sights at this time of the day.
The Cradle Mountain Huts Walk has exclusive use of the only private hut accommodation along the track. The hot showers and warm beds are a massive plus, but the food is what will really win you over.
So for tonight's main, we've got gamekeeper chipolatas and a warm barley salad.
Delicious.